welcome you to Pathway to Calvary. For the next half hour, we invite you to join us for inspiring music and ministry from God's Word. And now, from Calvary Christian Center in Alameda, California, here's today's program.
Thank you.
We'd like to invite you to join us this week at Calvary Christian Center in Alameda. On Sundays, our Sunday school classes for all ages meet at 9:30 a.m. Adult worship and children's church begin at 10:30 a.m. And our evening celebration of praise is at 6 p.m. Nursery care is provided for in all services. Our midweek service is on Thursdays at 7 p.m. In this service, we feature Bible study for adults, Roll Rangers for young boys, and missionette groups for young girls. Join us this week at Calvary Christian Center in Alameda. Our address is 1516 Grand Street, Alameda, California, 94501. For more information, call us at 415-521-1943. I'm so happy that you're with us today on Pathway to Calvary. My name is Pastor Dale Robbins of Calvary Christian Center in Alameda, California. We'd love for you to come by and visit with us sometime in the near future at our church right there where we worship the Lord and praise the Lord each Sunday and each week. This morning, I'm going to be sharing on a message that I call The Battle is the Lord's. And I hope that you'll follow with me. If you have a Bible in your home, we'd sure appreciate for you to turn in your Bible and follow along, or follow with a scripture that you'll see on your screen in just a moment. Something I like to tell people, check me out, that if I'm preaching and speaking from the Word of God. Now, this is the source of everything that we're sharing, is from the Bible. And check this out for yourself in the Word of God and see that the Bible has the solution for all your problems. Just like this message today, I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ has a solution, whether you have a physical problem, if you have a nervous problem, if you have a problem with fear in your life, if you have a problem with a lack of peace and joy. You know, Jesus Christ can come into your life and give you that joy and peace that you're missing in your life, if you would just call upon Him and trust Him. If you have a problem with your marriage, a problem at your job, if you have needs in your life, you see Jesus Christ in the Bible has come to meet our needs, both spiritual and physical. And this is what we're going to be sharing in just a moment. But I'm going to be reading from 2 Chronicles chapter 20. And we're going to be talking about Jehoshaphat. He was the king of Judah during a very crucial period of their history. And really, what happened here, the children of Judah, Jehoshaphat, had obeyed the Lord prior to this. And because of obedience to the Lord, they found themselves in a bit of a bind. Now, this is characteristic of being a Christian. Sometimes, because we have obeyed the Lord and done what He has asked us to do, we may suffer persecution, or we may find ourselves in a bit of a bind because we have lived for the Lord. But I want you to know that even though that there are costs of living for Jesus Christ, of course, we receive the greatest benefits in the world of living for Jesus Christ. We have Him at our disposal to minister to us and help us in our every time of need. But there are, of course, a bit of a cost to serving God, and sometimes we are persecuted, or we sometimes find our friends don't want us to be their friends anymore because we believe in God. But don't be afraid of that, because God has a solution even in that. And as a matter of fact, Scripture tells us, for everything that we forsake in the favor of living for God, God will return to us 100-fold in this life and in the life to come. That's Scripture. But let's read first in 2 Chronicles 20 and verse 10, and follow with the Scripture that you see on your screen right now. "And now, behold, the children of Ammon and of Moab and Mount Seir, whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and destroyed them not. Behold, I say, how they reward us to come cast us out of thy possession, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, wilt thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us, neither know we what to do. But our eyes are upon thee. And all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children, and then upon Jehaziel, and on down, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. And he said, Hearken ye all Judah and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thus thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's." Now the Scripture that we have just read today, as we already talked about, is a battle
that the children of Judah were facing because they had not destroyed these people of Moab, of Mount Seir and Ammon. They had obeyed the Lord and not destroyed these people. But now they found that these same tribes, what they had shown mercy to in obedience to the Lord, were now again their enemy. And they had compiled themselves together and now were coming in against Judah. And so Jehoshaphat and all the people of Judah realized the great insurmountable numbers that were coming against them. They were outnumbered. They were coming from every side. And now they only had one source, one choice to turn to, and that was to turn to God. God could only be their help. They didn't know what to do. And I can really associate with what Jehoshaphat is saying here in the Word of God, is that there are times in which we come to a situation that we don't know what to do. I have reached that place many times in my life. I have reached that position physically in my body. I don't know what to do. I hurt or I am in pain. There have been situations that I've had illness, extreme, grave illness, and I haven't known what to do. The doctor hasn't had an answer or there hasn't been a solution in this physical world. And I've turned to God and I have found that God has the answer. He has the answer for our physical needs. He has our answer for our material needs. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know that when I first started in the ministry as an evangelist, I had no guarantee of an income or money that would come in each week. And it was merely trusting God without even seeing any provider of any kind in the flesh. We started out from our particular home, traveled in a little trailer, didn't even have any meetings set up in advance. We went to college campuses, would hand out tracts and minister one-to-one on the street. And as we did all these things, it was sheerly by faith that somehow God would meet our need. And God did meet our need. And by extraordinary means, many times, God would bring someone our way or bring a situation our way that our income would always be met. God has an answer for our financial needs, our physical needs. He has an answer for our spiritual needs. And of course, we know the Bible tells us that there is no other way to God except through Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us, Jesus said these words in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Christ is the access into the Father so that we can have a relationship with God, so that He can fill and bring that inner contentment of peace and joy that we need in our life. You know, there are many people that are going through various avenues in this world, trying to find a sense of satisfaction. Some are in the bar rooms at this very moment, trying to find their satisfaction and peace of mind in the bottom of a glass. And we know that that's not going to happen that way. There are many other avenues that people search. They search through trying to find an avenue through the pleasures of this world. But you see, there is an inner void in us that is like a vacuum if we could say it, a hole in us, that only God is the right shape that can fill that void in us. He has made us that way. We have a spiritual nature, and only Jesus Christ can provide us access for God and His Holy Spirit to come into our lives and fill that void that we can have joy and peace. There is something missing in every man and woman's life until they receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Well, even as God had an answer for Jehoshaphat when everything seemed to be going wrong, and he didn't know what to do, and I very much associate with these words, he looked upon the circumstances, they were all against him. I've looked out and saw the circumstances against our ministry. I've seen everything going wrong many times, situations just aren't going the way they should, and I want to be and have been many times just like Jehoshaphat. Lord, we don't know what to do, but our eyes are upon Thee. That's the time that we need to trust God the greatest. We know that many times when the trials are the greatest, the victory is that much closer. I had a pastor that used to tell me when I was younger that when things get tough, our miracle is right around the corner. It's just like the devil that wants to hold it up and cause us problems just before that miracle comes through. But ladies and gentlemen, Jehoshaphat turned to the right source. He said, neither know we what to do, Lord, but our eyes are upon Thee. And then he and the children of Judah and all the people, they gathered together and they sought God and prayed. And then came the Spirit of the Lord upon Jehaziel and used him in a word of prophecy. And then the Lord came into their midst in this message and said, do not be afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude. And he said some words that we should remember today and never forget. He said, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Now, you know, ladies and gentlemen, it's important that we understand that when we do have a battle and when we do have a problem, we have to turn that battle over to the Lord. And that's one of the greatest difficulties that many people have in understanding that they can turn the battle over to God. You know, the scripture says, Jesus said these words, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You see, Jesus specializes in taking the burdens from our shoulders. Jesus specializes in taking away the hassles that we're dealing with in this life. That is a part of what Jesus has gone to the cross for, is to take all the hassles and burdens that you have. Now, he went primarily to take your sins upon himself, upon that cross nearly 2,000 years ago. But I want you to know that he was hung up for your hang-ups. He took every burden, every hang-up, every difficulty upon himself, and he wants you to trust in him today and allow him to take the heavy load that is off from your shoulders today. Would you do that in Jesus' name? Trust him and put your substitution of your burdens upon Jesus Christ today. That's what he is waiting for. That's what he is wanting. Sometimes people think that God only wants those better things in your life. He wants our money. He wants our time and these type of things. But I want you to know that he wants your bad stuff. He wants the things that you're hung up about. He wants your offenses. He wants your burdens. He wants your hurt feelings. He wants the scars in your heart. Those things that have gone wrong in your life, he wants to take those. He wants to heal them. I want you to know Jesus isn't a crutch today. He's a healer. He comes into your life and he makes all things new. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. He's a healer. He's a creator. He's a regenerator. He makes us new in our life. And he can make that new in your life today if you'll trust him. But he had the answer for Jehoshaphat. And Jehoshaphat went to the Lord, as we said. They prayed, sought God. God came into the midst with this great encouragement. And God said, the battle's not yours, Jehoshaphat. The battle's not yours, children of Judah, but the battle is the Lord's. Now, God takes over that battle once we commit the battle to him. Once we surrender it to him. There's a scripture in Hebrews that tells us, he that has ceased from his works has entered into rest. And what that means is we can never really have peace and rest in the Lord until we cease from our own striving to get things done. Our own worries, our own fretfulness, and our own fears, we've got to leave them to the Lord. And that's the only way that we're ever going to have peace and joy in our life, is simply let God be in control. You know, the Greyhound Bus Company several years ago had the slogan, you know, leave the driving to us. And that's exactly what Jesus wants you to do in your life, is to leave the driving to him. Entrust your life. Entrust your direction. As a matter of fact, did you know the scripture tells us to take no thought for tomorrow, what may come? Take no thought for raiment and various needs in our life, that even the fowls of the air, God has provided for them. He provided for the sparrows. He's provided for the lilies of the field. And oh, so much more shall he provide your needs. If you'll entrust to him your needs and your problems and the provisions that you have need of, God cares about you today. And he wants to minister to you if you'll just entrust your faith to him. Well, Jehoshaphat, the story concludes with the fact that when the Spirit of the Lord came in the midst of the congregation and encouraged them and told them that the battle is not theirs now, but the Lord's. And remember that that happens when we look to the Lord and we substitute our burdens upon him. Then the scripture tells us that under the direction of the Lord, they then sent out the praisers. And their army marched behind those praisers and worshipers. Now, the word Judah in Hebrew means praise. And the people of Judah were well known and renowned for their praise and worship to God. David was one that came from the tribe of Judah. And David was noted for his melody on the harp and his ability to worship and to praise. In fact, the Psalms, much of which came from David, are the type of chorus book or the type of song book of the Bible. They were meant really to be sung by. And many people, in fact, today sing by the Psalms that are written in the Old Testament there. But the children of Judah, they marched toward the enemy, those of the Ammonites, the Moabites, and those of Mount Seir. They marched toward them. But instead of sending the mightiest warriors out ahead of them, they sent the praisers. And they just went out praising God and worshiping God and crying out, "The Lord is good, His mercy endureth forever." And it tells us as they went out ahead of the armies of Judah, that God sent ambushments against the enemy and they were slain. And just think of it today. What a comparison. What a parallel to your life and mine. After we have committed the battle to the Lord, we need to be assured of His ability and of His power and of His enablement to take charge of that situation. And what we need to do, ladies and gentlemen, is just march right ahead into the conflicting circumstances and the problems, praising and worshiping the Lord. And just being thankful and praising God because He is in charge. Ladies and gentlemen, when we have a problem and we commit it to the Lord, we just then must begin to praise and worship God because He is in charge. He's taking care of it. He's working it out. And we just need to march ahead in worship and in praise and in thanks and in adoration to the Lord. And I want you to know there's power in praise. The Bible tells us that God inhabits the praises of His people. And when we begin to praise and worship the Lord, that's when the Spirit of God begins to move in our life and move in the lives of others around us. As a matter of fact, there is scripture to indicate that because of our praise and our worship, and when you go to God's house, and when you go to church, and when you go to church and your pastor encourages you to worship and praise the Lord, please enter in and lift your hands if you would like and close your eyes and begin to praise and adore the Lord and watch His Spirit begin to move in your heart and move in the lives of people around you. There's power in praise. I want you to know praise releases the power of God. Praise is an act of confidence in God. Praise is worshiping the God that you cannot see by your natural eyes. It's an expression of faith. Praise, no wonder, brings the gifts of the Spirit moving in our congregations and moving in our lives. And when you have committed your battle and your burden to the Lord, then just go out and praise and thanks. Now, this morning, I just feel that there are individuals that are fighting battles and experiencing problems. And I would like for you right now, if you do have a problem, I want you to commit it to the Lord. You may have a marital problem. You may have a problem with your children. You may have a problem with your job. You may not make enough money. You may be hurting right now in your physical body. I want you to commit that to the Lord. Lord, just like Jehoshaphat, I don't know what to do. The circumstances are beyond me. It seems like the enemy is more than my strength. But Lord, I'm looking to You. I'm putting my faith and my confidence in You, just like Jehoshaphat did way back here, hundreds and hundreds of years ago. And after you've committed that battle to the Lord and you just turn it over to Him, I want you then just begin praising God. Would you? Just lift your hands wherever you are. And I don't care how foolish it may seem to you. Just lift your hands, begin to praise the Lord. And allow the Holy Spirit begin to bring His peace and His joy into your life. Just praise Him. Just worship Him. And thank Him. If you're there by yourself, just lift your hands and praise the Lord. If there are people with you, go right ahead. Praise the Lord and worship God and just allow His Spirit to begin, and you'll begin to feel that peace. You may even feel it already, the peace and the joy that's coming as we praise and worship God, because He's in control. He's in charge, my friend. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if there is one of you that is watching that Jesus Christ has not yet become your Savior and Lord, I want you to know that His arms are out to you right now. He is only waiting for you to surrender your life to Him. Would you do that? And you know, ladies and gentlemen, there is only one way that we can be saved, and that's through the precious blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If you don't know Him as your Savior and Lord, I want you right now to call upon the Lord and ask Him to come into your heart and your life. And someone said, well, how do I do that? You just talk to Him just like your friend, just like I'm talking to you right now. Just talk to Him and say, Jesus, forgive me, I'm a sinner. Cleanse me of my sins, come into my heart and save me. Did you know that every invitation for Jesus Christ to come into a heart is answered? There is no one that Jesus will ever turn away. You say, perhaps you're one that might say, well, I've committed too many sins. I have done too many bad things. I want you to know there is no sin that Christ cannot forgive. You may be one that says, well, I don't have any sin. I'm a pretty good person. But yet, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. None are righteous, no, not one. You say, well, I don't see sin in my life. You see, sin is more than just various acts that you do. Sin is an entire nature that we have inherited from Adam and Eve's sin. There is sin that has come upon humanity. sickness and disease and crime and poverty, all these things are symptoms and signs of sin that is in the world. Now, these are not exactly sin themselves, but these are derivatives and these are products of sin in the world. And so, ladies and gentlemen, commit your life to Jesus Christ. Commit your sinful condition to Jesus Christ for salvation. And He has an array of benefits He'll give to you in your life as you commit your life to Him and you begin to serve Him. Well, today, I hope that you've enjoyed what we have had to say. I hope this is encouraging to you. If you would like a cassette message of this tape in your home, this program is program 102A, excuse me. And if you want this cassette tape, please write us or call us and give us that number, 102A, the number that you see on your screen, and let us know and we'll get that to you. We ask for the cost of the tape only, and we would appreciate that very, very much. Well, until next time, this is Pastor Dale Robbins. I love you, and I appreciate you very much. Tune us in again on Pathway to Calvary. God bless you.
We'd like to invite you to join us this week at Calvary Christian Center in Alameda. On Sundays, our Sunday school classes for all ages meet at 9:30 a.m. Adult worship and children's church begin at 10:30 a.m. And our evening celebration of praise is at 6 p.m. Nursery care is provided for in all services. Our midweek service is on Thursdays at 7 p.m. In this service, we feature Bible study for adults, role rangers for young boys, and missionette groups for young girls. Join us this week at Calvary Christian Center in Alameda. Our address is 1516 Grand Street, Alameda, California, 94501. For more information, call us at 415-521-1943.